In this video, I'm going to demonstrate NAGs. NAGs stands for Natural Apophyseal Glide. Indication for the NAGs are gross motion loss, elderly patient having severe spondylitic changes, post-manipulative soreness, or you can also use this technique for checking the irritability of the cervical spine. Patient must not complain pain while delivering this technique and after this technique. If delivered properly, patient will have instant pain relief and there will be increase in range of motion. It is best delivered between C2 to C6 level. It is delivered between mid to end range and it's going to be oscillatory in nature and oscillation is going to be 1 to 2 per second. You will stand next to the patient and your outer leg will be in the front while the inner leg will go behind. You will use pillow to stabilize patient. Stabilize shoulder of the patient with the help of pillow and your groin area. Hold the head in neutral position and hook the desired level of the spinous process with the middle phalanx of your little finger, while the other three fingers are going to stabilize the upper vertebra. In this case, when I'm nagging C5-6, I'm going to hook the spinous process of C5 and my ring finger, middle finger and index finger are going to stabilize C2-3-4 vertebra. And I'm going to push this portion of my little finger with the lateral border of my thinner eminence. I'll hook it, take out the slack and then push it gently at the speed of 1 to 2 per second towards the eyeball of the patient. That is anterior cranially. And why I'm pushing anterior cranially? Because this is what the treatment plane of the C5-6 is, oblique towards the eyeball. And in this case, to demonstrate properly, I'm going to hook it, hook the C6 spinous process, and this is what the treatment plane is, anterior cranially, it is going oblique in this direction. So I'm going to hook the spinous process with my little finger, other three fingers will stabilize other vertebra and then push it towards the eyeball of the patient. In case I want to do unilateral, I'll just simply put my same portion of the little finger on the facet joint and then again push it towards the eyeball of the patient. For doing central nag, I'm going to hook the spinous process and then push it towards the eyeball of the patient. While doing unilateral nag, if the pain is on one side, I'm going to hook the facet joint and then push it again towards the eyeball of the patient. Make sure you're pushing with the lateral border of the thinner eminence, not the hypothinner eminence. You're not pushing with the pulp of the thumb. You're not taking the patient towards you because it's a gross motion loss. This will cause pain. And make sure only your this leg is forward, not this leg. In some cases, when patient is having hyperlordotic spine, so you may ask patient to do chin tuck, so you can hook the spinous process properly. In case you want to do nag with traction, you can hook the spinous process and instead of putting equal weight on your both feet, you shift your body weight to your back foot, so patient will automatically get traction and then you gently push it towards the eyeball of the patient. If delivered properly, patient will have no pain and there will be instant increase in range of motion. This is called NAGs, Natural Apophyseal Glide. To watch more video series on Manual of Mulligan Concept, you may subscribe to my YouTube channel. In case you have any doubt or query, please comment and please share this video with your physio friends. Thank you very much.